Hello again, my name is Simon, and in this video I'm going to talk about acoustics and reflections and show you how to best set up your recording space. The recording space you choose can have a huge impact on the sound of your recording. As sound bounces around the room, it combines to distort and colour the sound. This will affect your recording and can lower the sound quality. It can also become a distraction for the listener, making it hard for them to focus on what's being said. So it's really important to set up your room in a way that will minimise those reflections before you hit the record button. Step 1. Choosing the right room. Firstly, start by choosing the best room to record in. Every room has its own unique sound. This is due to the size and shape of the room, and also the construction type and furnishings. For example, a large room with carpet and curtains will sound very different to a small room with a concrete floor. The best way to find out if a room will sound any good is to listen. You can do this by using your recording machine to make a test recording in a few different rooms. Hold the microphone at arm's length and set the gain while counting to 5. Then record yourself doing this in each room to hear the difference. Make sure you speak at the same level and don't change the input gain in between each room.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
And when you're done, find a quiet location to listen back to the recordings. Outside or in a car would work well. Remember, this video is about controlling reflections within the room. It's not about stopping noise from outside the room. So before you think about acoustics, make sure your room is in a quiet location. Step 2, applying acoustic treatment. Okay, so here I am, I found my room, but no room is perfect. So once you've found the best room possible, it's time to start thinking about adding some acoustic treatment. Because I'm using a directional microphone, I'm going to add something soft behind and to the sides of my language helper to absorb the reflections. I'm using some fiberglass insulation wrapped in fabric, but a mattress or some large cushions will work just as well. But be careful. Adding too much absorption can leave your room sounding a bit bassy as all the high frequencies are sucked up by the cushions. If you're unsure, make another test recording and have a listen. Remember though, not all hard surfaces are bad. Uneven surfaces such as a bookshelf full of different sized books are a great way to break up reflections without absorbing those high frequencies. Step 3, setting up to record. Once you've chosen your room and added any acoustic treatment, it's time to set up to record. Place the language helper in the room, keeping them at least 1 meter from any walls and away from the corners. Often a table may be used in the recording room. Remember, this is a hard, flat surface, so it's important to make sure the table is not positioned in a way that will reflect the sound and color your recording. It can also help to cover it with thick blankets. And no, a regular tablecloth won't help. Finally, the position of the microphone in relation to the language helper can drastically affect the amount of room that is heard on the recording. This is what my recording sounds like with the microphone 1 meter away. And this is what my recording sounds like with the microphone 10 to 15 centimeters away. Well, that's all for this tutorial. I hope you've enjoyed this video and that you can really hear the difference it can make to set up your room properly. I encourage you to experiment and try out some of the techniques in this video. And hopefully you'll discover how to make studio quality recordings without being in the studio. Bye.